Now, we move on in this. In verse 7 here, we read, "For the king trusteth in the Lord, and through the mercy of the Most High, he shall not be moved." We want to read on now in this other translation. I pick up here at verse 8, by the way. It says, "Thine hand shall find out all thine enemies." Now, he not only is a God of salvation, but because of his death upon the cross for sinners, those that have become his enemies, he knows them. "Thy hand shall find out all thine enemies. Thy right hand shall find out those that hate thee. Thou shalt make them as a fiery oven in the time of thy coming." You don't believe in hell? Bible teaches it, my friend. You're in disagreement with the Bible. Man came to me and said, "I don't believe in hell." And I said to him, "You know you're in disagreement with the Bible?" He said, "I don't care. I don't believe in it." Well, I said, "You will someday. You're going to believe in it someday. You better believe in it now, my friend. In fact, someday you'll know whether it's true or not." Now, hell's not a pleasant subject. Who said it was? God says he does not take any delight in the lost. God's strange work is called judgment. His wonderful work is salvation. He wants to save. But if you won't have it his way and his salvation, then there's nothing but judgment that remains. Listen to him here. "Thou shalt make them as a fiery oven in the time of thy coming. Jehovah shall swallow them up in his wrath, and the fire shall devour them." Friends, that's very clear. I think fire is fire, and judgment is judgment. "Listen, their fruit shalt thou destroy from the earth, and their seed from among the children of men. For they intended evil against thee. They devised mischief, unable to perform. For thou wilt make them turn their back. With thy strings wilt thou aim at their faces. Be thou exalted in thy strength, Jehovah. We will sing and praise thy power." This is a marvelous psalm. We saw the cross and the sufferings in this psalm. And he did it for the joy that was set before him, because he could save you and me. And his prayers have been answered. Now the king's in heaven. We see him there crowned with glory and honor. He's there in behalf of his people. He's there in unspeakable joy and waiting for his manifestation in kingly glory. I'd like to give you another picture of the Lord Jesus today. A man of sorrows and acquainted with grief. Somebody says in every picture I've ever seen of him is a solemn, serious-looking Christ. I don't believe that's the way he looks today. I don't know how he looks, and I don't care for the pictures. May I say to you, he's right under God's right hand right now, and his heart's just filled with joy. And he wants to communicate that joy to you and me today. Oh, that you and I might get a glimpse of him today. And his enemies conspired against him when he was down here. And he lent himself to those. And we find that his enemies here conspire against him. They attempt to get to him. And though he's there today in unspeakable joy, and he's waiting for his manifestation in wonderful glory. Now, he was on earth, and he was trusting in Jehovah. His enemies conspired against him. And as that vision in Revelation, you remember, it's in Revelation 12, the dragon wanted to devour the man-child. Well, now that dragon is Satan. The man-child is Christ, and the woman is Israel. But the child, we're told, was caught up to God and to his throne, and he was destined to rule all nations with the rod of iron. That's where he is right now. You see that Satan, if he'd stayed down here in the weakness of humanity, Satan would have destroyed him. But he's been caught up to heaven. This is a great psalm, you see, of the ascension of the Lord Jesus. He finished our salvation for us. And he cannot be moved, we're told here. He cannot be moved. Verse 7, he shall not be moved. What a glorious, wonderful picture. And you have picture judgment. And this is not the only one. It's in Revelation. I tell you, it's a pretty serious picture that's given to us there. And then Paul mentions in 2 Thessalonians, the first chapter, listen to this. In 2 Thessalonians 1, verse 7, "And to you who are troubled, rest with us when the Lord Jesus shall be revealed from heaven with his mighty angels in flaming fire, taking vengeance on them that know not God and that obey not the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, who shall be punished with everlasting destruction from the presence of the Lord and from the glory of his power, when he shall come to be glorified in his saints and to be admired in all them that believe, because our testimony among you was believed in that day." What a picture that you have here of him coming in judgment for his enemies. My friend, this is a glorious psalm of the ascension of Christ, and it is. And by the way, what is your relationship to him today? If he's not your Savior, if you haven't trusted the one who came down here to die, and he today is filled with joy up yonder because he wrought out your salvation in mine. Now, if you want to turn your back on it, then judgment is coming. This very psalm of the ascension makes it very clear of the wonderful, glorious grace of God in Christ, and in that same one, judgment.